Hey everyone, how's it going? JoeTes here with another Pokemon DS friend match. And this is against JoeTestrikesBack. I actually know this guy on YouTube and he's actually a really cool guy. He's actually helped me out with a lot of things along the way. He's actually a really good guy. If you haven't subscribed to him, go subscribe to him. This guy is definitely worthy of it. And as I'm sure you've noticed, we are having a triple battle. Now, I'm going to be honest with you guys. You'll have to excuse my other bad play, because in this battle I wasn't actually that good because I was ill at the time when I had this match and I just wasn't thinking properly, I wasn't thinking straight, you know. I mean, I'm still a bit ill now, but you know, I'm not as ill as I was when I had this, so you'll have to excuse my poor play because I did actually make quite a lot of stupid mistakes. But then again, in the long run, it wasn't that bad a battle overall, and so I activate the mummy ability of Kofagrus, and I'm thinking I'll just go for a crunch because, you know, just get rid of that thing as soon as possible. But he gets rid of my Moxie for mummy, which is like, oh dang it. But it's actually a really cool strategy for what you'll see soon, because he's actually done something really cool here. And I actually knew he was going to Trick Room, but I didn't think to get rid of his Ridiculous. I think it's mainly because I wanted to try and get down Manitan's favourites on it, but I just couldn't because of, you know, the rules of Triple Battle. So, he has his, something. What was it? Something new, Sucker Punch, I don't know what it was. And I think it was, I don't know, you guys saw what happened anyway. So, actually really cool because now, he's slacking, which I think it was slacking that used for Sucker Punch. Activate his My Mummy ability, you know, because he's changed my ability to Mummy, and that gets rid of Trons, which is really good. That's a really good strategy there. So he goes for a Sleep Powder on my Mind Shell, which is like, oh, dang it, this is not good. And I was just about to KO that thing with High Jump Kick. So, Kukutar goes for another Crunch, because I really want to get rid of this Ridiculous, because I know we can set up Trick Room. But, it does a lot of damage, but doesn't knock it out, because Ridiculous is actually pretty good. Go for a superpower on Slaking because, well, what else am I supposed to do? It's the best choice I have on this thing. And it doesn't do that. Oh my god, I beg your pardon. No, it does quite a lot actually. But it actually lives, which is like, oh dang it. But it is to be expected because Trick Room Pokemon, because they don't have any speed EVs, they are usually more bulky than they are fast because of Trick Room. And I lose my Darmanitan due to the Flareblitz recoil. And my Mind Shell is asleep, so this is not looking good, you know. In all fairness, I need to get me a triples battle, a triples team, because I can tell that his team is actually very team-oriented. It's very well put together, I suppose I say so myself. Well, yeah, for him, that is. Yeah. And of course, he has his Clefable. I don't know why he's called it Clefable. I'm sure there's a reason, but, you know. So he has Ridiculous, go for a Jello Ball, opposite to kill off my Crocodile. His Ouija, Tangela in this case, goes for a Leech Seed on my Milotic, very good play on his part. Milotic goes for an Ice Beam, yeah, so I'm like, I can go for an Ice Beam, but it barely lives. I'm like, oh, dang it, come on. So he has his Slaking, go for a, what is it, a blooming Trick Room, not Trick Room, Slack Off, sorry, I'm just not with it today. So, Mind Shell does wake up, which is good news for me, which means I can finally get rid of that Tangela, which means I haven't got to worry about being put to sleep. Yeah. And, just going to say Clefable, it's freaking ridiculous. this is ridiculous. So, he brings in his Tyranitar, which, of course, I've given the team, I can understand. I'm going to get my Metagross now, because I'm like, I'll go for multiple that Metagross. I think Metagross is my last guy, actually. So, anyway, of course, Sandstorm is going to come because of, you know, Tyranitar Sandstream. Go for the Body Punch, just because I want to break that Air Balloon of his, and plus, it does a bit of damage. You know, but at least now I've got to worry about that Air Balloon. Go for a Psyshock here, and of course, it's obviously going to KO because it's, well, it's Mind Shell's very frail and weak to Psychic, so yeah, you know. So Mind Shell goes down, which is a shame. And it is a Tyranitar, goes for a Substitute. I've got no idea, well, I'm sure there's a reason why, but you know. I go for an ice beam with my Lotic, but I do actually get the freeze hacks, which is kind of hacksy, but you know, yeah, I am actually losing this quite badly. So, anyway, I've actually only got two guys left. He's still got four, which is like, oh dang it, I really did not do well in this match. So, anyway, he goes for, of course, because of Leech Seed and all that, you know, I'm going to be losing HP to that, and he's going to be getting HP back. Really good setup, gotta admit, this team is so well designed. I really like this team. Oh no, I've still got my Bravery, I forgot about Bravery, even though it actually works against me because its Trick Room is still up. So he has his Ridiculous go for a Focus Blast. So, of course he can't target Melotic, but, you know, it goes for Metagross, it doesn't do that much actually, but yeah, he goes for an Ice Beam, so I'm guessing it's that Tyranny Boa set that's got Substitute and like, you know, the Bulb Beam combo and Focus Punch or something. I think that's the normal set of Tyranny Boa. So, I go for a Meteor Mash on a Slugging, hoping it would kill, but it doesn't. But it doesn't actually matter that much because, you know, yeah, he's still frozen. Yeah, and Melotic goes for a Surfer. This is where I did some stupid moves, right? I should have just gone for the Ice Beam on a Slugging to get rid of it faster. Admittedly, it doesn't matter that much. I think the main reason I did that was to get rid of a oh, I'm gonna, that's why. Okay, yeah, never mind. That was actually a good play on my part. You know, because, you know, it got rid of the sub and it got rid of Slugging. And I actually do manage to get rid of his Ridiculous as well. So, kind of fighting back a bit hard here, despite the fact that I wasn't hit well at the time. So, I do manage to get rid of his Ridiculous at last. But unfortunately, I lose my Bravery. Oh, no, I don't. Sorry. I thought I lost Bravery. Oh, actually, yeah, I do. I use my Bravery to the Sandstorm. Oh, no, I don't. Goodness me, I can't get anything right today, can I? Sorry, guys. So, you know. So, yeah, my Bravery does actually survive the recoil and the Sandstorm, amazingly. But I don't think it matters that much because, oh, no, it does matter, actually. Yeah, it does matter. So, it brings in Rhyperior now. Rhyperior is awesome. It's great for a Trick Room team. I go for the Brave Bird. I thought I might as well just go for Tyranitar because, you know. I just don't know why, actually. I just thought I'd go for Tyranitar. So, of course, now I'm definitely going to die. You know, I'm not going to live that. No Bravery can survive that. This is where I made a dumb play. Alright, you know, I killed my own Metagross off. I thought, oh, dang it, I should have gone for Ice Beam. If I'd gone for Ice Beam, I could have, you know, I could have actually have gotten rid of that Tyranitar and actually had a chance to win. So, too bad. So he goes for a Curse with Rhyperior, and I think it's pretty obvious at this point. I suppose, how does this part of the battle work? I mean, he's technically to the far left, I'm to the far right. How would that work? I mean, I can't target it. Does the rules change when it reaches this point of the game or something? I don't know. You can leave your comments below on how troubles work in this situation. So then, as you can tell, I think this is my first trouble battle. So anyway, that's the end of the match. So, thank you very much for watching. Good game, JoeTes. I hope we can battle again soon when I've got a more well-organized team. And anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you all later.